Hello, Mermit. So, I have been to three RPG Day. This is basically an event that are held in a lot of gaming stores and comic book stores, where basically role-playing game companies give out, they're usually adventure supplements for free. And of course that is because in most of the supplements you have a little bit of a blurb about how to play the game, and then a group gather up to play one of these modules, and they decide they like the game and they buy the books. That's of course how it works. That's how they earn money on it and how they can do it. It's advertisement, but it's a nice form of advertisement. I also bought a few things while I was at the gaming store. So, I thought I would do a haul. So, I can start with the things I bought. Because they had some, usually when they have these sort of events, they have a lot of good, have a lot of good deals. So I got a Funko Pop, that's about half off, which is Phoebe from Mass Effect Andromeda, and they have this stand with books that are really, really cheap, like a third or a fourth of the price they usually are. So I got the first Machine Dynasty, VN, by Madeline Ashby. Is that is how she's supposed to be, her name is supposed to be said. And let me just, because I think I got another book in that series as well. One little bookie, where are you? I think I just have to go with what I can grab. And I got Timothy Zahn Soulminder. And Tom Pollock, The Glass Republic. These are all fantasy and science fiction. Here's the other one. The second Machine Dynasty, Id by Madeline Ashbery. And here is another book. The Lady of the Streets by Tom Pollock. I got those books and I got a pair of dice. I can find them. Just these here, D6s. There was another pair, there was another set of dice I wanted, but they were sold out. Really, really like this one here, if you can find it. So, something for the dice collection. And then I can get on the goodies that are actually part of Free Comic Book Day. So what? No, there's one more thing we bought. There's one more thing we bought. Me and my husband got one each. Is these coasters? The rainbow that says "I don't even think straight." Thought they were cool. So yeah, there's that. Now we get to the Free Comic Book Day stuff. And I haven't really had time to go over a lot of this because it was my father-in-law that drove me down there, so I didn't really have a lot of time to just go and peruse the shelves and look over things. We have a Midnight Legion, Last Recruit, an interactive adventure where you decide what happens next. Which game is this for? It's a complete solo adventure, so it isn't for a particular game. It seems it's a prequel to the Midnight Legion game book series. Yeah, so it's for Midnight Legion. And then I got this one here, which is Overlight
Birthright of Kar Ulan, role playing game of kaleidoscopic journeys.
Let's see if we can figure out which game this is for. It's a preview of the forthcoming Overlight role playing game from Renegade Game Studio. So, this is not an adventure in itself, it's basically the when they release the most basic games so that you can run a session of it.
That's nice.
And here we have Numera, Ashes of the Sea, which is a module for Numera. It's a game I have, and it's really, really good. And we have for Starfinder, if I don't remember correctly, I do have that one, which is Skittershot, which is also an adventure, and those little creatures are adorable. And my baggie decided to fall over. We have TNT Adventures Japan, everything you need to game, play including rules, manga, comic, and a solitaire adventure. Yeah, it's Tunnels and Trolls. I haven't heard talk about Tunnels and Trolls since, forever. I remember when I first started role-playing, that was a thing, but since then I haven't, it's not a game I have, and since that time, and I was like 16 at the time, I haven't really heard much about that game. So, let's put some here. We have two supplements hanging together. We have Call of Cthulhu. Scratch. What terror lurks within the gloomy woodlands surrounding a sleepy English village? If we are going to believe the various crime mystery shows my mother likes to watch, nothing good. A modern play, a modern day Call of Cthulhu scenario for 2 to 6 players. This is one of the ones I really looked forward to because I really like Call of Cthulhu. My only complaint is that it has this Satan's Ballsack type fell velvety cover, but I can live with it. It was free. And then we have a level 1 adventure module for 5th edition Fantasy. It's for Dungeons and Dragons 5th edition, which I do have. It's been called Beneath the Keep. You see a cute little, I think she's probably a half-elf lady there with a nice dagger. I suspect she might be a thief, a half-elf thief. And then we have, looks like it might be two things in one book. It's bigger than the other ones. It's Cthulhu Confidential, A Cable's Length from Shore, and The Fall of Delta Green for Delta Green, on a bank by the moonlight. Let's see if I correct. Yeah, they are two. It's one for Call of Cthulhu, or it's not actually Call of Cthulhu, it's Cthulhu Confidential. It's basically one for Cthulhu Confidential, one for Delta Green modules. That's nice. Very nice. Let me just dive down here and get some more. I mean, you can get some hours of entertainment out of this for free, because first you have to read the modules, and then you can run some game nights with this. We have one for Pathfinder, we have VB Super Goblins, and this really looks really, really fun. So it's an adventure for Pathfinder, and yeah. So yeah. And then we have a 5th edition adventure, one more for Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition adventure, The Sword of
rum. And here it seems to have a draw. It could be a regular elf, it's just a bit just the lighting. But it looks to me to be a draw with a very fancy hair tie going on and a sword. And she doesn't look to be too happy. But yeah, Adventure for Dungeons and Dragons 5th edition. And then we have Warhammer 40,000, Wrath of Glory, Blessings, Blessings Unheralded. I didn't know they were gonna do a Warhammer 40,000 roleplay thing, or I would have been really excited. But yeah, here we go. This one was the one that I knew they were gonna have, and that I was most excited about. It's for Unknown Armies, Mania in the Parts. That sounds like an interesting condition. I'm a huge Unknown Armies fan, so yeah, I was so excited about this one. And let's dig it down here again. Yeah, one here is called Kids on Bikes, Free RPG Day Edition. A role-playing game about small towns and big adventures. What is this for? It doesn't actually say. I think it might be enough here to play with. It's basically Stranger Things, the role-playing game, which could be fun. Absolutely, that could be fun. And then we have Dungeon Crawl Classics. Role-playing game, quick start rules on intro adventure. I haven't heard about this. And it's together with Godman Games, Free RPG Day. It seems to be two in one thing. And probably then for something called Dungeon Crawl Classics. I'm actually not sure what this is at all. But I guess I will find out. And now I don't think we have anything more but the dice. But let's not forget the dice. Never forget the dice. So yeah, they had some more different dice. But they didn't have a lot of dice. It wasn't really a dice enough for everybody, so I didn't get too grabby. We got three of them. So, first of all, we have this. Let's see if I can get it to focus properly. It's the die for this Free RPG Day. It's basically 12th annual Free RPG Day, June 16, 2018, it says there. It's not a very, very good print, but the die itself is quite pretty. And then there's these two things from Games Workshop that says Viking die. So I'll open them up. Do I have a pair of scissors there somewhere? I do. Well, there's an example of their things. I mean, they had others, but I grabbed a D12 and a D10. So yeah, I didn't want to get too grabby with the dice. Leave some for somebody else as well. But these are actually really nice dice. I might have to get some sets of these, which I guess is why they're giving these samples out for free, because then people think, ooh, I like this, I think I will give you my money. So, yeah. This one is from a dark blue with orange-red letters. So you see these, it's these decorations, and then the numbers are in the center. And then I actually like this design better on the D12. It is bright blue with bright, almost metallic blue with these rather simple designs and numbers in the center. And was there anything? Yeah, there was this little token card for Munchkin collectible card game. I don't have that game, but I think this card is adorable. So I just needed to have this, and I think I will be using this as a bookmark. So even if there were no point in getting it, if you didn't play this game, I wanted this little worm thingy. Anyway, so yeah, that was my free RPG day haul. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Have a great day, and blessed be.